We are here at Bluff Bucks Outfitters, Rugged Cross Outdoors 2021. And we are excited to have our 2021 Youth Hunt Giveaway winner, Carson, and his dad, Jeff, with us today. And it's Saturday morning, first day of the hunt, and we'll be going out into the woods here in a couple hours. Here at Bluff Bucks Outfitters, they just hunt in the evenings because we're going to be hunting on the edge of some food plots. And so we'll be in either a ground blind or a Banks tower blind. And Carson here has never harvested deer, correct?
Nope.
So this is your first time out?
Yep.
And so we're excited to have Carson with us on this trip. We have 2 days to get it done. Carson can shoot one deer, either a buck or a doe. So I'm pretty sure your plan is to do what?
Aim for a deer.
What about today? Are we going to shoot anything, or what are we thinking?
If it's big enough,
we're going to hold off for a little bit bigger of a buck today, it sounds like.
Yeah.
No doe.
And then no doe?
Not today.
All right, we'll see what happens when he gets out there, folks. Yeah. We're excited to have you guys both here with our team. And it's going to be an exciting weekend. The weather's a little warm, a little humid. But it is what it is, so we're going to make the best of it and have a good time. I did want to give you both one of our official RCO gun hunt hats for you guys to have and wear. And then as well, I have our official RCO shirt. And so that's for you. I think that's the medium, and then this is a little bit larger for you. If that doesn't fit, let me know. But we wanted to give that to you guys on behalf of RCO and just to welcome you on this hunt. Any questions or anything about the hunt that you're curious about, or?
I think
we're good to go?
Yeah.
All right, well, about 2 o'clock, we're gonna head out. Like I said, we're gonna be on the edge of some food plots. And we're in world-renowned Buffalo County, Wisconsin, where there are big bucks. And we're excited to be back here again this year. And hopefully Carson here can get it done here in 2021, so. Good luck, my friend.
Thank you.
Let's get out there soon.
First day, ready to head out. Hunting over a food plot, hopefully. See something.
Let's get her done.
Get her done.
All right, you lead the way.
Just made it up in the stands. We're in the blind. We're over a nice big food plot. Got the hopefully come down from these woods over here, right in front of us. Thank you.
Well, it's day two of our Buffalo County 2021 youth hunt here with Carson, and we came in out of the heat. It's still pretty warm. It's warm and humid, and so we have one more afternoon. Yesterday we had a pretty decent day. Carson could have took his first deer. We saw, what did we see yesterday?
Nice 6-point. Didn't really want to, not on the first day. I was looking for something bigger, but
I saw a few does too. Saw about five does. And then that 6-point came out and taunted you for about a half an hour, but he wanted to hold off for one of these bigger Buffalo County bucks here in Wisconsin. But what about today? What's the game plan this afternoon?
If he walks back out, I'll take a shot, but really anything, I guess.
It's kind of hard when you sit in these cabins here and you see the plethora of giants on the wall. Yeah. Kind of makes you want to get your hands wrapped around one of those, doesn't it?
Yeah.
but Carson's never shot a deer before, like I mentioned yesterday, and so we're hoping that he can harvest his first deer today. So we're going to head back out in about 4 hours and see if we can get that done. So,
yeah.
You know, this is our youth hunt giveaway, and Carson was the lucky winner for 2021. And one of the things that they have to do to win this hunt is they have to fill out an application that I have in my hand. And then they have to write an essay, and amongst hundreds of people that apply for the hunt, we score those essays and applications, and Carson was our lucky winner this year. And one of the things that he has to do, like I mentioned, is he has to write an essay. And the question this year was, what could we do? What's one thing you could do if you were able to change our nation or to make a difference in our nation? And our motto at Rugged Cross Outdoors is making a difference in the lives of outdoor enthusiasts. It's kind of our tagline, so to speak. And so making a difference in people's lives is what we do. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that set you apart from the other people that applied for this hunt was your essay. And I really liked it. And, you know, I'll start out by saying that one of the biggest things that, you know, you had mentioned that our nation was facing was obviously COVID last year. We were fortunate enough to still have this hunt, but many of our events and speaking events were all canceled because of COVID. You mentioned unemployment, businesses closing, and just the deterioration of unity in our nation. And that really kind of tugged on my heart and Andy's heart, because I think you were spot on. You talked a lot about mental health in your essay. Why did those things stand out for you?
I mean, as a 13-year-old, or 14 now, I can't go and change the president or do anything anywhere else. So what I can do is just be nice and kind and...
Yeah, you can only control what you can control, you know. And I think that was the other piece of his essay, that your essay that I really liked was, and I'll kind of quote this because I don't want to steal your words. He said in here, "The beauty of our nation is the fact that it is diverse, it is unique, and it possesses freedoms that other countries do not have. We need to step back, remember what makes our country so great. If everyone turned hate into love and understanding, arguing into listening, selfishness into thoughtfulness, we could start to make a difference. And that difference can start with one 13-year-old. And that one 13-year-old is me, Carson Conley." And that last closing paragraph, I thought, really summed it up really well, is you can only do what you can do, right? And that is to treat people... honestly, you know, as a Christian ministry, to treat people the way God wants us to treat people.
Mm-hmm.
And that's to love one another. And that's to appreciate one another and honor one another and serve and support others. And that's what I really liked about your essay. And so, you know, that really pretty much sealed the deal for you to win this hunt. And so it was a great essay. I think you honed in on one of the things that's talked about probably the most in the Bible is love. And loving one another. It's our commandment to love God and to love one another, the two biggest commandments in the Bible. And I think you touched upon that indirectly in your essay. And I wanted to share just a quick verse that God kind of put on my heart earlier this morning, and it's from Romans 12:10. It says, "Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourselves." And we can't, as a nation,
really change if we don't put others above ourselves, and that we don't respect other people's diversity. And we've gotten so bad as a nation that if you don't believe in this political stance, then we don't like you. Or if you are anti-abortion, we don't like you. Or if, you know what I mean? Is that kind of where you were going with that?
Yeah, I think if we all just, doesn't matter on what your thoughts on something, as long as you all love each other and be kind, it doesn't matter.
And that's really what our ministry is about, is just serving and pouring into our youth, such as yourself, people with developmental disabilities, you mentioned in your essay, people with mental health issues. That's my profession. I do that for a living. I support people with disabilities and people with mental health issues. And God calls us to love everybody, you know, regardless of who we are, what we believe, whether it's right or wrong. We're called to love one another, and that is probably what one of the reasons why you won this hunt. And it was a great essay. I have a couple things for you that we want to take with you. Of course, one of our fancy Rugged Cross Outdoor backpacks. And then inside is your very own The Heart of the Outdoors Bible. And so it's full Bible, and then it's got outdoor stories, hunting stories, and things like that for you to have. And then our good friend Steve Sorensen is the author of this 30-Day Hunt for Faith. And it's just a daily devotional for 1 month that takes you through each day for 30 days. And it's got different hunting topics, biblical concepts, and things like this. And Andy and I and Rugged Cross Outdoors have used this when we've spoke at different youth events and things. And so it's got some really great content in here to develop and grow your faith over a 30-day period. And so that is yours as well. And your handy-dandy backpack. So they're small and compact, and they're meant to be able to take out in the field with you if you want to take them out hunting. Because as you know from yesterday, there's a lot of downtime in the stand. Right?
Yeah.
So we've got one more afternoon here with Carson, and God willing, we're going to get it done tonight. So I hope that you can harvest your first deer.
Me too.
All right, man, let's do it.
All right, let's do it.
Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this opportunity to be out in your creation, Lord. We thank you for Carson and Jeff and the time spent with him and new friends, Lord. And we just praise you just to be out here in your kingdom, Lord. And we just ask that you be with us tonight. Keep everybody safe, including all the hunters that will be out this afternoon. Lord, we just pray your hands of success upon this hunt, Lord. We pray that you guide Carson's shot, guide my camera work, Lord, and present us with an opportunity tonight, Lord, as well as the other kids. We just have a great, safe hunt, Lord. In your name I pray, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Second day, in the same spot over this food plot. Hoping for that 6-point to come back, or something bigger. And it's warmer than yesterday, but got a nice breeze coming through here, so hopefully we get something. Get it done.
Thank you.
You hit her. Keep an eye on where she goes. She's right there.
Yeah?
Get on her. She's going down. She's down, buddy. Yeah. You got your first deer, buddy.
Yeah.
You got your first deer. Give me some. Good job.
She's still squirming around.
Yeah, just keep an eye on her.
Yeah, she's not going anywhere. She's kicking.
Keep an eye on her.
Baby gone?
Congratulations, man. What do you think? Talk to me.
Long time coming to that. Kept on, had that front leg always behind her that entire time.
Yeah. She didn't want to open up her vitals, did she?
No. She was probably just comfortable eating that way. Heart's racing.
Good. That's the way it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
Tell me what's going on.
A lot going on here. Mm-hmm. Shot the doe and now there's two more. Two bucks just walked out. Another.
Two bucks and a doe? Or?
Yeah, two bucks and a doe.
And we're just sitting here talking and they're not paying no attention to us.
Yeah, they're just eating. I don't care. We could get out of the stand and they'd probably still be eating.
Talk to me. Tell me what happened.
Well, she came down somewhere right up front here. We were looking at her. I was like, shoot her. And got lined up. She kept on putting that front leg behind her. Once she gave me the opportunity, nailed her. Went about 20 yards. Flopped and there she lays.
Good job, buddy.
Yeah.
Good job.
Anybody you want to thank?
Thank Bluff Bucks out and Rugged Cross Outdoors for this opportunity. It's just great people, great organizations. Thank you guys.